Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall. We are going to quest until the final level attainable in the Fighter Skills. Currently, we are a warrior, and the final level would be a master. And to that effect, I'm going to try to limit myself to quests that are simpler to do. Now, I will not be shying away from the standard dungeon crawl. However, at the same time, if the dungeon has... What's up with you? Getting in my face all like that. Anyway. So yeah, I will not be shying away from dungeon crawls. However, if the dungeon has enemies such as, vampire ancients and things that will drain my resources. Yeah, this guy isn't stopping, is he? I wonder what's wrong with him. Maybe because the max number of people are already gathered around with him, I suppose. So yeah, like I was saying, I'm not gonna address those dungeons wherein, you know, there were vampire ancients or things like that that would drain me of my resources. So yeah, with that being said, let's go ahead and make a save here. And let us quest until we get the next rank. I like you, kid. This assignment ain't for just anyone. Seems there's a flock of flying carnivores, harpies, who are making a bunch of traveling merchants real nervous. Will 716 gold get you over to the Sahelor Goniva Grotto and a little hacking and slashing? Sure. Okay then, there are five of those beauties in the grotto. I'm not even gonna try to... Sahelor Goniva. Okay, Sahelor Goniva. And grotto, and they all gotta be dead in 8 days or no deal. And a word of advice, you get back here in 8 days, but get to the grotto as soon as possible, or those harpies are gonna migrate and you'll be out of luck. Okay, kid. Good luck and get out of here. Alright, so Sahelor Goniva. That's a strange name, to be honest. I don't think I've ever come across a name like Sahelor Goniva in this game before. But the reason I'm repeating that so much is, well, simply because I'm trying to remember it, to type it in right now. Okay, the Sahelor Goniva. Wah, grotto. Sure. ship, foot, yeah. It's all the same to me, really. Since we are already equipped with this, might as well just go ahead and use it. Now, this is not exactly a dungeon crawl. You just crawl a little bit into the dungeon and then you just wait there until the harpies come to you. And that's how you play this. Ideally, it would have to be like a someplace in the middle, which can be frequented by monsters. So, yeah. I feel like I'm addressing this quest pretty late into the game, but, well, I don't really mind. There are enemies nearby, of course there are. Which way should we go? Anyway, it doesn't really matter because what we're trying to do in the end is just kill us some harpies. That's all that we really want to do, to be honest. And in the process, if we find some good loot, might as well get it. Alright, I forgot to change my interaction mode. It's been a while since I played this game. Like 4 days, but it always feels like it's been a while since I played this game every time that I boot it up. Enemies nearby. Oh, wait. It's that dungeon module. The pink stuff on the floor, is that supposed to be like blood of some sort? Or is that just the coloring? I think it's just the coloring, right? These look shiny, and I would have liked to wear them, but I've got far better boots, so it's sort of redundant to want to wear them right now, to be honest. I'm gonna loiter here for 3 hours, of course. Enemies, the first harpy, yay! Come here. Now, the thing about harpies, right, is that you can avoid fighting with them altogether if your harpy is leveled up. So, yeah. Until fully healed, of course, I'm healed. There's another harpy. Amazing! And this one flew right at me because it wanted to actually fight. The other one, though, I'm not sure whether it was being passive or just... Well... didn't detect me yet. I finished loitering. I'm gonna try and loiter here a little more. Ideally, yes. So, with these quests, as long as you just keep loitering about in the place, the enemies will come to you on their own. So, the enemies aren't actually in the dungeon; they just get spawned near you as you are, as and when you know you. That's an attack sign. Ooh, that was brutal. I think that's the harpy. It got literally pushed back all the way. And that's four there. So, last harpy. So yeah, these guys aren't actually in the dungeon, they just get spawned near you at certain intervals. And that's how it works, to be honest. I'm gonna try and loiter a while more. Yes, thank you. Come here. All the way back. Thank you. That's five. That should be enough to hold the quester. Or rather, the quester's name. Alright. Back we go. And yeah, this is essentially... Although it may seem like I am not exactly addressing this quest properly, the truth is that that's just how this quest is meant to be done. Because otherwise you'll keep exploring the dungeon and ultimately you'll just end up, you know, exploring the entirety of the dungeon while still finding your quest objectives every now and then, and you'll be wondering to yourself, I already cleared this area, how did this thing get here? It's not supposed to be here. And yeah, so this is a far more time and resource economic way of clearing this quest. And the more sensible way, to be honest. Now, of course, if you are in the mood for some dungeon crawling, be my guest, go ahead and crawl the dungeon all you want. But remember that you will not find what you're looking for that way. Alright, kid, good going. That's 716 gold your way, not too shabby. Hey, since you've been so helpful, here's a map to Castle Kingfield. All the killing and looting you can stand, my treat. Really now, why is Kingfield a region in the area? I wonder. I can't carry anymore. I guess I'll just deny the reward then. Oh well. But there's something that of course I can't check it from here, but I'll check it when I go back out. So let's get the next quest from this guy then. Just as to Greenham, a wave request from a local citizen, it seems a wild animal has gotten into his place, we need someone to go kill the thing. The guild will pay 618 gold, do you want it, Grimfangs? Sure. Okay, Grimfangs, get over to the house of Tipella here in town. Get it done in one day. Nobody wants an animal left roaming around in their place. Come back here when the beast is dead and I'll have your pay waiting for you. Tristester Greenham calls out, hey, what kind of animal is it in the house of Tibella? You hear a voice call out from an upper floor, it's a bear. As if that matters, to be honest. Maybe it does to like a lower level player, but to us it actually does not. I'm just gonna put that back in. Now the reason I was laughing is that is because I am a member of the House of Tabella, and here I am, their savior from the Fighters Guild, ridding the beast for them. Like, if only they had trusted me enough to assign that task to me, send me a missive, ask me to take care of the bear, I would have gladly done it for them for free, and it would have raised my reputation with them as well. But they just had to ask the Fighters Guild, and the Fighters Guild instead assigned the quest to me, so here we are. A perfectly fine member of your own organization, ridding you of your troubles for a cost. Just because you did not trust them to do the job in the first place. And I just realized that I'm gonna have to mark this video as age restricted now. I can hear the bear. Ah, there it is. The side profile sort of look like a rhino there, to be honest. The bear is dead. Body has no treasure, so I'll just be looting this this pile over here. That has some treasure. Alright. Beating a bear to death with nothing but our bare fists. Check. I don't know why I can't speak today. Now to head back to the fighter skills. Like Koegria, I've got it, like at least as far as the main areas are concerned, I have more or less got it memorized. The routes and stuff, the directions in which I need to go. And they are quite conveniently placed as well, placed at the very edges of town. So you can't really get lost while searching for them. Alright. Well done, Grimfangs. Here's 618 gold, which I probably can't carry anyway. Okay, let's make another save here. And let us talk to you for yet another quest. I wonder what you'll give us this time. Listen, Grimfangs, if you hadn't already done a bunch of jobs with us already, I wouldn't even suggest this, but there's a job I don't even want to tell you about. It sounds like crying for the moon and more dangerous. It's offing a lich in Castle Kingfield. Didn't you literally just give me a... what do you call it? A map pointing to Castle Kingfield just a few minutes ago? Before we had this conversation? Yes, you did. And now I'm to go there. Do you only give things out to people for your own personal profit, is it? And it only pays 721 gold. You're not interested, are you? To be honest, I typically would accept this, but right now I want to preserve my resources, and since it involves Lich, nah, I'm gonna pass on this. Thank Julianus, you got a little sense left. We'll just let that Lich do whatever the hell it wants to do. That's fine with me. Now, here's the funny thing. Fighter Skull did tell you to go, like, kill a bunch of giants, and they're like, decent job, here's a gold. The Knight's Guild, it tells you to go slay a giant, and when you, just one giant, mind you, and when you successfully slay a giant, the quest is like, oh my, I'm so honored to be shaking the hand of a giant slayer. And these guys, when they tell you to go, Fighters Guild, I mean, when they tell you to go kill stuff like liches, they'll be like, ah, oh, thank God you refused it. That seems sensible. That seems sensible. The Knights Guild, however, on the other hand, they're like, oh yeah, there's this lich. You need to go dispose of it. But no worries, it's just a regular lich. And when you've done the job, they're like, good job. Here's a may your reputation precede you. That's literally it. That's literally everything. Strange, to be honest. Get a quest. We've got a little job you might be interested in. Seems there's a loop. What you call your basic werewolf, werebore, or some kind of werebeastie that's been bothering a lot of farmers in the area, and we'll need someone to kill it. It'll mean 770 gold in your pocket. That sounds interesting. Sure. Great. You'll find the loop over in the ruins of old Moorheart place. You'll need the poor brute dead in 7 days, so you better be on your way, kid. Alright, let's see Moorheart place. I hope that it does not have any vampires and liches and stuff like that. If it does, I'm just gonna go to the same safe. That was the place, right? Old Moorheart place. Right. My bad. The old Moorheart place. Really? Is it supposed to be old Moorheart Palace? No? Old Moorheart Palace? Okay, how about we just search for Moorheart? There isn't? Interesting. What am I reading wrong? Moorheart. The old ruins of the old Moorheart good heart, please. Yeah, the naming conventions of Daggerfall. Old mood heart, please. That seems to be a minor crypt, to be honest. Oh right, I forgot to equip this. But if it is like the minor crypt that it is supposed to be, I don't think it'll be... Oh no, it was marked in dark green, dark red. I think the color coding is like this, like if something is marked in dark red, that's supposed to be like an actual dungeon, and the light orange ones are supposed to be, well, just crypts. So I don't know what this is though. Maybe it's like an actual dungeon. Who knows? Let us go crawling. And if there are any vampire ancients and stuff in there, we're hightailing it out of here. Okay, two paths in front of us right off the bat. Let's go towards the broken wheel. Let's see what this place has to offer us. That's a dragonling, one of the enemies that I used to have a ton of issues with early on in the game, and they spawn no loot whatsoever. So dragonlings are both a positive and a negative sign. Positive because, well, it suggests that this dungeon isn't as high level to be having, you know, daedrots and well, daedra actually, not daedrots. Daedras aren't an issue. Daedra are to be having daedra and vampire ancients and stuff. At the same time, these guys aren't exactly the most easy preys either. I mean, right now you can see that this thing isn't really doing a lot of damage to me, but well, they can fuck you up in a heartbeat when you're a new level player, like when you're underleveled. A lot of dragonlings, a lot of dragonlings here. The reason I keep stepping back like that is to avoid its flame attack, which can cause a great deal of damage, so yeah. That's another pathway, and this seems to be leading up to a restroom of sorts. Nothing here. I guess I'll just rest here until I'm fully healed. Keep topping my health up. But I do feel positive about the fact that I've only seen dragonlings thus far, and orc shamans from the look of it. It's the first time I've seen this orc shaman here. 240 pieces of gold that I could pick up. Now this is interesting. Daedric left baldron. New. Honestly, I would like to equip this, but I cannot carry any more stuff. Excuse me, though. So, you know what? This is this piece of armor is pretty new, so I doubt it's. I doubt it's been worn at all. So, yeah, we might as well keep it on, to be honest. This, yeah, even that is new. Yeah, does not make sense to carry it with us. Orc shamans and dragonlings, that's fine by me for now. And a human enemy. I wonder where the werewolf could be. That's a monk, of all things. Ooh, that's a... That would sell for a lot, but I can't really pick up anything else. That seems amazing, but I've already got a better left baldron. I'm just going where the road takes me, to be honest. And that is how I've resorted to dungeon crawling these days, unless it's like a mainline dungeon instead of, you know. Crawling every nook and cranny, I don't really sweat it as much. Yeah, let's go that way, why not? It seemingly ends in a dead end. Unless... No, it's just dead end. Nothing else here. Right? Yeah, nothing else here. Just this door there. which doesn't really open up anywhere except for a place with this wooden stick in the middle, which keeps disappearing. I don't even have the bandwidth to carry anymore. There's this huge stick in the middle that's barring my progress from going over to the other side, and that's an issue. However, the other side does not have anything either, so might as well get back. There are like no hidden doors, and I don't really think there are any. Well, the map does not show any hidden doors, so there must be none. And there aren't any, like, a whole lot of interactable items that we can interact with either. So I suppose we just keep heading forward. I have to admit that this dungeon layout is very new to me. I've never seen a dungeon layout like this before. So it does have the sense of, novelty to it. If only you guys had any treasure on you. Oh, hi there. Since we have turned this way anyway to face that human, might as well go ahead and finish him. Most likely, yeah. I heard the scorpion behind the door, but that scorpion was frantic. Frantically searching for something. Ooh, shit. But that guy I did not expect there. Do I want to? Yep, I do. Free action. Alright, we're coming to you. It's like this guy could not hit us, so he started shooting arrows at us. Which is a very bad tendency that these guys have. Of course, I cannot take your gold either. What about you? Do you have anything of value? Just gold? Okay. Hawk Shaman also died. Sometimes some of these places might have like a... Yep, we're not addressing this dungeon anymore. So the thing is, sometimes some of these dungeons might have like the random lich or the random vampire ancient, but it's typically only one of those folks, and it's more like a misallocation of resources, to be honest. It's like they don't always spawn in, and whenever they do, it's like this only one of these guys throughout the entire dungeon, and you don't really have to keep fighting them. So when that lich came at me, I was like, well, it's fine, we don't really need to take him on, we can get by without doing that either. When you see at least two of these guys, that means that the entire dungeon is full of them. So yeah, continuing to crawl that dungeon to look for that weird thing, whatever it is, werebear, werewolf or whatever, would be pretty well counterproductive to our goals right now, because I want to preserve all of my potions of resist fire, resist shock and resist frost, because, well, we are going someplace where we will be requiring all of them. So to that effect, I've been stocking up potions as much as I can, given how rare they are to find in this game, and I have been essentially, well, avoiding these kinds of quests as much as possible, unless it's a mainline quest, of course. Some woodsmen have hired the guild to kill this brigand. Seems the monster is attacking them when they are out in the woods logging. Want to take a hack at it, Grimfangs? Sure. Two attempted ambushes have failed. This brigand is just too smart. You'll have to go to its lair in Hearthcroft's guard. Get back to me within 7 days, and I'll have 696 gold waiting for you. But I wonder why some of the easier quests get me like 717 gold, but some of the harder quests get me less gold. Hearthcroft's guard. Right. Hearthcroft's guard. Yes, of course. Right, I forgot to. My luck is affected, I wonder why that is. It is worn, okay. Am I healthy though? I'm healthy. So I wonder how my luck is affected then. It's. Did I drop it on the ground? Yes, I did. How stupid of me. Can I not pick it up? Excuse me. Thank you. Thank this game for being 3D. Damn. And it would have sucked even more if they had told me that I do not have the space to carry it. That would have really sucked. Really? It's like this marsh here? Like a moat in front of the castle? Then again, I suppose that's what a castle. There's a cat right here. And the music hasn't really changed either. I wonder what's going on. This is the place to go, right? It's not really giving me any information about the place. I'm gonna assume this is the place, and there's like even the cat and everything there. Okay. Easy way to confirm is to just open this up. Hearthcroft's card. Yeah. Yes, yes it is. I see an orc shaman who eated a spell at me. Orc shaman died. Cool. Now since you pointed me in this direction, I'm gonna start my, well, search in this direction. And right off the bat, I'm unable to pick up anything. Nobody opened any doors. That is strange. Okay, giant scorpions. Some more loot. I hear what sounds like scorpions. Resist frost. Let us keep this in our. Of course, I can't. How about I drop like 50 gold? Will I be able to pick you up then? Thank you. That I feel like is the worth of the potion anyway. 50 gold. If I'm not misremembering things, that sounds like something. Or just a scorpion. I doubt there are any hidden doors and passages along this route here. Does not seem to be the case. Another giant scorpion from what inside what is presumably a tiny room with no end to it. Now scorpions I'm still fine to take on because at most I'm gonna have to use like a potion of cure poison to heal it. Since there is an orc stationed right here. We're gonna head over this way. I heard a door opening somewhere. Most likely here. That's another orc. Orc warlord, dead. What is this orc strength? Now, are you an imposter, sir? Why would you require a potion of orc strength when you yourself are an orc? You, sir, are an imposter, not an orc. They should unblood you, if possible. You're a fake, a forgery, a disgrace to orcs. That's what you are. Well, that's not exactly the guy that we're looking for, so we're just gonna walk past that guy. Somebody opened this door to give us some daydraws. Daydraws aren't really that big of an issue, they just... I mean, as long as you're not like a mage parchment. I'll try equipping this. Of course I cannot use it. Ah. How about you drop like 25 gold and then maybe I'll be able to equip it. How about I drop 25 more gold? Maybe then I'll be able to equip it. How about I drop 25 more gold? Now, how much gold do I need to drop to equip this piece of paper. My god. 25. I'll try dropping 25 gold again. How heavy is this parchment? Really? That was just a parchment. And I dropped all that gold for no reason. Well, I don't mind to be honest, because gold holds no value to me anymore. It's locked in the store. Now, you know what would suck? There's like an orc shaman right behind us. And he just blasts me with a couple of high damage spells as soon as I open that door. Which is what almost happened. I hear more rocks. Nobody here, but I do hear more rocks. Probably in the surrounding rooms. I'll try picking up some gold. Cannot carry anymore, of course. That's an ox warlord. I was about to say sergeant, but apparently it's a warlord. This guy hit hard. Enemies nearby. Alright. We'll just take them out before we go any further then. Like, these levels can be stressful. This is just a room, just to mark it off on the map. Just another empty room, as is typical. This dungeon layout should be another empty room. Oh no, it's a larger empty room. Maybe I can rest here. Yes, I can. Excuse me there. Somebody opened this door for us. It was that this orc sergeant right here. Sorry, warlord. I wonder where we are supposed to go. I hear the clinking of metal on metal. Oh, okay. I am sort of relieved, because I thought for a second that, yeah. So, see, this thing that the Daedroth just did to us, it's called Silence. And whenever Silence is cast upon you, you cannot cast any spells. So, Daedroths are pretty dangerous for spellcasters, I would say. For us. Have we come, like, full circle? Yes, we have. Yes, we have. Oh hey! We apparently... No, we didn't. That, I think, was near the dungeon entrance. Where was the dungeon entrance, I wonder? It was supposedly somewhere over here, right? Yes. It was right here, see? This yellow thing. This green-yellow thing. That's basically the dungeon entrance. And now that we're here, where else are we? Have we not explored yet? I suppose the right, the path on the right then. That remains yet unexplored by us. There is something orcish behind this door. Oh, come here. That was a warlord. Oh, amazing. Let me just remove my boots and put these nice boots on. How much gold do I have to draw for this? 100? Will that do? No. 100 more? Let's amp up the process. 250? One piece. Okay. 250 more. One piece. Ooh, amazing. Right, now then. Since we have dropped all of the gold, can we put this back in our inventory? Of course we cannot. I guess we'll just leave it here. And with that, our Daedric gear is almost complete. We just need a Daedric cuirass and a pair of Daedric gauntlets. Good, good. I would say that's good progress. Let me just go ahead and save here. because I haven't saved in this dungeon yet. Playing it in Iron Man mode. For whatever twisted reason. That's a Daedroth and a... Excuse me. I'm surprised that that guy did not go invisible. I would have expected that guy to go invisible, to be honest. The Orc Shaman, I mean. It's floating in the air for whatever reason. What's behind this door, I wonder? Ooh, an entire armory. See, rooms like these were meant to be looted. Were meant to be pretty much lootable. However... Well, it was never implemented in the game. Boxes, ammunition racks, sorry, weapon racks, they were all meant to be lootable. But never fully implemented in the game. Oh hey, I've leveled up. So what do we want to level up? Should we just put all four in speed then? That would put endurance, strength and speed at the same level, so I guess I'll do that. 75 is a decent amount, I believe. I feel like. Maybe I can sleep in one of their beds here. Excuse me. Let me just top up the save. And I don't know whether it's just placebo or what, but I can certainly feel the effects of the speed boost. I feel like I'm moving a little faster. Marginally, but a little faster nonetheless. Orc Sergeant, that was an Orc Sergeant. It's nigh impossible to find greaves on the enemies. So I guess we have done like a full circle, except for the room on the left up ahead. Which I was quite certain that, oh yeah, we never entered it completely, did we? We did not. Alright, so we head back downstairs then. Spriggan, 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 where are you, Spriggan? Alright, so since we're here, where else could we go? I feel like there was like a part of the map that we had not yet completely explored. Like this part right here. We could keep exploring this side. So we exit here and we take a right and then we take another right. 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 There's also that area over there that we never really explored, we just came up all of a sudden. But yeah, we can keep going back there. For now, let's just explore this side. Unless it seems already explored. Oh well. I guess we're going over to that side then. And how do we get back down there? Well, we follow these stairs to go all the way down, and then we can like go left and we can go forward as well, so might as well. Follow those trails then. Pick up where we left off. We can go straight or we can take a right. Let's take a right. We'll explore the road street on our way back. I hear a knock. But what I'm really looking for is this Spriggan though. Sidestab successful is what I'd say, but unfortunately, water breathing, absolutely not. Remove all your gold, of course I cannot remove any of your gold. Why would I be able to? That would be too easy, wouldn't it? Not carrying more stuff, okay. So we've got two routes, two doors here. One of them opens up to a quest room. Where quest objectives might sometimes be, and this one opens up into a hallway. At this point, let me just go ahead and save here. Now, where do we want to go? Hi, Scorpion. It's the overhead hook combination. an overhead attack, an overhead punch followed by a hook. And let's go upstairs. Oh, hi, Ox Sergeant. It was left-right hook, straight combination. you can tell when somebody's bored when they start making up combination names for weapon attacks in the game. Hi, Daydroth. Bye, Daydroth. Seriously, some of these guys have such terrible loot, I swear. This is another area that might have occasionally some quest objective. Sometimes, not always, sometimes. So I'm gonna save here again. Oh, okay, that's we're right next to the entrance now. And if you want to, we can look to the left there, but you know what, maybe should we just keep exploring that side then? I'm curious about what's over on this side, since we never haven't really been here. That's a Daydroth. Sometimes these guys hit hard. Sometimes they're like total pushovers. So difficult to tell which one you're gonna encounter. Now the reason I'm covering this side is the fact that a lot of times the quest objectives tend to be right next to the entrance. This, I feel like we've already been here, but it's like a copy of the layout of the place that we have already been to. We have not actually been here. And is that it? No hidden doors whatsoever here? Fine. That works for me. Oh, back up we go. I'm glad I came here. And yeah. This right here would be the way. Just marking it off and making sure that there are no hidden doors there. That area was more or less useless. We'll conduct a deeper level search later. For now, let's head back to where we were and let's keep churning in our hunt for this brigand. We shall turn this dungeon upside down and in the process kill as many orcs and beasts as needed. Invisibility? That's nice. Some of these orcs apparently can't remember how the potions work, or how the spells work for that matter, and hence they rely on things like potions. Now, I should probably save in the emergency slot here, because as far as I recall, this was just like Ox Sergeant died. That door is already open, which is quite strange because I don't recall opening that door. Is this a hidden door? No, apparently not. Is that like a loot room? Seems to be the case. Yeah, typically these things are dead ends, but in this case it was not. And I am sort of glad that I came here. I cannot carry any more stuff. Now, how many rupees do I need to drop now? Let's start with 250. Ash House scripts, which you copied on. Now, right now, to be honest, we don't really need any of these maps, and I don't intend on doing any independent exploration either, but from time to time, these maps can prove to be quite invaluable. Oh, this was a hidden door. Okay. I wonder where this brings me out. Didn't expect to see you there, but got you before you could get me. And I'm glad I did. This seems to be a kind of crypt. Pretty sure this is gonna be like a just an Oksham, nothing else. I was about to say pretty sure there's gonna be like a bunch of knights popping out of this area, because this dungeon module typically is accompanied by knights This was probably supposed to be a kind of meeting room for kings and stuff. Which was never really programmed into the game, like most of the content in this game. And as a result, it's half-baked in. I'm healed, I'm healed. My stealth skill is improved. I'm gonna override this save slot, and... Oh, Warlord is dead. That would have fetched a lot of money if I could carry it. I can't even carry gold at this point. I wonder what's weighing me down so much. Maybe it's all the Daedric gear that I'm decked out with. We have not been here before, no. Oh, I don't mind exploring. Now, since you already activated me, like I already activated you, might as well go ahead and deal with you first. So see, that's the benefit of having speed. The fact that you can get in multiple shots on your opponent before they are able to. No, there should be a spriggan. Sorry, there should be a hidden door right here. And if our luck shines, the spriggan should be right behind it. But of course it's not. Because why would our luck shine? Just roses and stuff, flowers, which I would typically pick up, but yeah, I don't think I need them anymore. I think I've reached a point in the game where I'm far more comfortable reading the maps as compared to before. Or rather, should I say, far more proficient at reading the maps as compared to before. Ah, okay, so I now understand where I got branched off. We went there, and then that side. And then we did clear that side off, right? Yes, because that's what led us here in the first place. So I guess we can continue exploring what's behind us, and... have we explored the other side, though? We seemingly have. Except for this part. Well, we can go ahead and explore it later. So, for now, I'll just continue exploring this side. I see a Warlord right here. Backstab! More like backbash, but... yeah. Doesn't it suck when you're unaware of the opponent and they just walk up behind you and break your spine? Or bash your head in. Probably an orc behind this door. From the sounds I could have sworn it was an orc, but I suppose... yeah, that was you, wasn't it? The guy who was making all those noises.
Noises, noises, people make noises when they're sick.
I don't know whether my microphone picked that up or not. There's the spriggan. The spriggan is that those woodsmen can log in safely now. Alright, do you have any loot for us? Except for... apparently not. Alright, we are going to be saving the game here. And reporting back to the quester for our reward. I hope this is the right way. Is it not? Yes, yes it is. It's just a long way. It's a long way to the top if you wanna rock and roll. Yeah, so we just need to get here and then... I do believe it will lead us where we want to go. Because this path here joins here, and then this path here joins back to the main dungeon area, and this area is completely unexplored. I thought we had explored that. So, yeah. So we just go all the way up here, take a right, and then go up the stairs. Right, nice. Up the stairs we go, and at the first sign, at the first intersection, excuse me, we take a left, and right here is where we need to go. No, I want to report back my quest, thank you very much. And there's a cat parked right outside, but given the nature of the enemies in this place, I do not think that is too big of a, you know, something to be concerned about. Koegria, Koegria, here we come. Foot horse. Time to go to Koegria on foot horse. We are entering Koegria and we are well fortified. Excuse me. Anyway, this should be enough to get us a promotion in the guild. I'm sort of sad that this brigand died in one hit, but then again, it is a pretty low level enemy. Even though it is quite rare, you don't really get to see a brigand apart from when a quest points you towards one like this. And let us talk to you. This brigand is Kinlink? You're proving yourself to be quite reliable, warrior. No shit. By the way, since I'm feeling charitable, here's a map to a hole called Helker, full of monsters needing killing. Treasure to loot, the works, have fun. Well, if you're into that kind of stuff. I'm just gonna save the game up here again, and I'm gonna talk to you. I'll be needing another quest from the looks of it, because, well, I haven't gotten promoted yet. I like you, kid. This assignment ain't for just anyone. Seems there's a flock of flying carnivores, harpies, who are making a bunch of traveling merchants real nervous. You know what, I just recall that I haven't wasted enough time. I have not wasted enough time yet. Between promotions, I have not yet wasted a month. That's probably the reason that I'm not promoted yet. Let me just fuck off somewhere and essentially spend some time. Joyous Relic of Arcade. Travel time 30 days. Well, let's shorten that time a bit. I like the change of scenario, to be honest. Anyhow, we'll be going back to Koegria and we'll be finding Koegria. And yeah, by ship, of course. That spends 26 days on top of the days that we've already spent, and I think at this point we should be ready for the promotion. If not, we'll just go ahead and do another quest. So that's just one of the issues with having only one quest to come, you know, having only one affiliation in which you're trying to gain mastery, is the fact that you need to wait a long, long time in between quests. I feel like we would have already crossed the 30-day threshold with our journeys. So let's go back in and talk to the quester for a promotion then. Since it's early in the morning, the guild is only open to us. Yep, that was the issue. I was wondering, how is it that I am having to complete 4 quests for a promotion? Like, the fighter's guild tends to get wonky at times, and sometimes it will not promote you with just, you know, 2 quests completed. Sometimes it demands 3 quests of you, which is why I completed the 3rd quest. But honestly, every successful quest gives you a +5 boost to your, you know, reputation with the guild. And, well, every rank is spaced out at intervals of 10 reps. So, essentially, 2 quests are enough to get you promoted to the next rank. And if you've got, like an odd number of like if you got some wonky number like I did with my reputation for the nobles of Fairest, you can essentially get promoted with just one quest itself. Congratulations, Grimfangs, because of your outstanding weaponry prowess, we have promoted you to the rank of master in the guild. Among other benefits, this means cheaper weapon repair and more profitable work assignments. And that's it. That's honestly the maximum rank that we can acquire in the fighter's guild, which is sort of sad, because I mean, I thought they would have congratulated us in somewhat of a better way, like the knightly order did, but I suppose that thing is just unique to knightly order. I mean, comparing both the guilds at this point, the knightly order, that is Knights of the Rose, or any knightly order for that matter, and the fighter's guild, the work for the fighter's guild is just for show. I mean, it doesn't have remotely the same sense of satisfaction that the knightly order can provide us with. And yeah, that's like, we can get to the logical for 2 hours. And yeah, it's like when I used to quest for the knightly orders, even though the quests usually were very intense, it would still I need to find it in place. 1136 gold. So yeah, even though the quests were very harrowing, it still was how do I put it? Very entertaining. I mean, the rewards were very, very entertaining. And in this, it just doesn't seem to be the same way, to be honest. So 1136, and how much? So he takes like a 1%. He takes 1% of the top, so that will bring us to 1125. The amount that we can take out. Okay, 1124 then. Right. And yeah, it's strange. It's strange. I mean, by the skill, it's like, eh, you got the rank of master. You're finally a master now. And ooh, longbow is 90%. God damn it. Blunt weapon is 61. Maybe we should switch over to the axe for the time being. Strength, agility. Agility is 66. Hey, that's interesting. I mean, of course, these don't really affect, you know, your like these stats don't really affect your actual weapon attributes as much as you think they would. If this was Arena, it would have affected it quite a lot. However, this is Daggerfall, so they forgot to scale it. Daggerfall runs on 100, on a scale of 100. Meanwhile, Arena runs on a scale of 20. So, even like on a d20, like a 20 random values. So they forgot to scale it up, and as a result, by the time you raise your value by 10 points, you'll get like a +1 bonus to all of your stats that your attributes govern. So essentially, increasing your attributes doesn't really help in this game. However, on the other end, your proficiency in a specific skill, that really does govern how proficient you are with that actual thing. So yeah, that's how it goes. Running is 100%, which is sort of insulting for a warrior, but stealth is 88%, again, sort of insulting for a warrior. Critical strike at least is nice. Backstabbing is 24%. The rest is 3%, 5%. How do I have 5% in mysticism? Spriggan is 6%. Nymph is 6%. What the hell? Giantess is 10. Orcish is 9%. Etiquette is lower than those. And how am I Destruction Illusion and Thaumaturgy? Up so high. Because of all the enchantments that I've been doing? Interesting. 4%. Not, I read that as 4.5. At least my lockpicking and pickpocket are still pretty poor, which is something that I can look forward to. Anyway, so that was that for this video, to be honest. It wasn't really entertaining, and the only reason that I did it was because it was, well, just one of the things that I wanted to do with my character, reaching the rank of master, that is, inside the, you know, fighter skills. And if I hadn't really wanted to do that, I would not have done that, to be honest. Like, if I hadn't really wanted to reach the rank of master, I would not have insisted on doing it. So, like, it wasn't a form of roleplay for me, is what I'm trying to say. So, yeah, but in the end, even doing the quests themselves wasn't as... That's one of the potions we need, as another potion we need. Entertaining, so to speak, and the rewards were very, very poor. I mean, I would have thought that, I mean, comparing the two guilds here, like the two factions here, one being the Pirates Guild, another being the Knights of the Rose, the rewards from the Knights of the Rose were far, far better. And honestly, I just feel like if that is a representation of how it is for the rest of the guilds as well, I'm sort of feeling sad for had to be in either the Mage's Guild or, any of the temples, as I'm planning to do with my mage, or Thieves Guild and the Dark Brotherhood, as I'm planning to do with my rogue character. But, it's sort of disappointing, the Pirate's Guild, to be honest. I mean, all it just entails is better pay, and that's honestly it. Better pay, cheaper weapon repair, which of course translates to better pay. But it doesn't really give you any added bonuses or benefits. I mean, the Knightly Order did not give you gold. It did not give you gold at all. But typically, it would not give you gold. Sometimes it would. There are like a few quests which should give you gold. But in most cases, it would not give you any kind of gold or any kind of, you know, material incentive. It would just raise your reputation. But whenever you got bumped up a rank, you would receive a new armor. And as you kept gaining newer and newer ranks, it would do things like, making travel free across the entire Iliac Bay region, or making you stay in the entire Iliac Bay region instead of any inn free, which is what I'm getting. So money is practically useless to me, unless right now it is to perhaps like buy some new weapons or armor or whatever. But speaking of, let me just go ahead and check out the armor shops. Maybe they might have some, you know, favorite equipment for us to put on. Like I was saying, the fighter skill on the other hand is just more money for doing the next quest onwards, more rewards. And even the rewards are pretty shabby, to be honest. They just give you, what, like 800 gold at the most? I mean, with this rank up to master, I'll get, what, 800 gold? 1050 gold? That seems pretty poor, to be honest. I mean, we could probably definitely get far better paid. We make far better money raiding dungeons. And weapon repairs, you don't really need to repair your weapons as often in this game either, so I don't really know what they were trying to accomplish by doing what they were doing, but it clearly did not work out. So, yeah, all in all, the fighter skills was very lackluster, in my opinion, and I only did it because it was one of the things that I wanted to do with my character, one of the forms of roleplay that I wanted to accomplish with my playable character. And that's honestly it. I had no other incentive to actually completing the fighter's guild first time, or rather reaching all the way to the rank of master. So yeah, with all that being said, I feel like I've been taking up a lot of your time, and as far as today's video is concerned, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. But the next time we come back, we will be targeting this missive that closing in miscellaneous. Now I need to find that missive from among this entire huge pile. Right here. Use. So this missive from Lady Brisienna, Lord Brisienna, which says, "Grimfangs, come at once to Nerdwood and invade us." So basically, she has something very important to tell us, which could concern the fate of the entire, well, empire. And that is essentially what we're going to check out. So, yeah. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow orphans.